It's time for single song shows. It's the 90th episode and the 2-year anniversary. So cheers to us. Yay! I see Gary Christiani's here. I see my dad. I see my guest, Joe Schwab, is here. Oh my goodness! I see Milan. I see Joey Baxter. I see Bardo Media. Hello, hello, everybody. Yeah! The 90s rule, says London Crow. You're right. You're right. That's factual. Let's see. I feel like I should just get freaking Joe on and get the party started. Kevin kind of got the party started because he made me hot chocolate upon my request. And it's really yummy. Hello! Cheers!
Howdy.
Got my hot chocolate here.
Hot chocolate.
Hot chocolate and
got a beer.
Nice. Yeah.
We just we finished practice. We practiced on Thursday nights, and so it was kind of a nice opportunity to like be warmed up and like kind of in the mood. And
oh heck yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. That's perfect. How'd practice go?
Great. It went great.
Hey, actually, a really nice segue to talk about shows that you have coming up. Did you want to mention that right now, and we can mention
it
again later?
So we're gonna play June 11th at the Rack and Tour Room in the Tascadero, and that's about all we've got booked at the moment. But we are looking to book other shows. We're also looking for other bands to book shows with, because we like to play shows with like multi-band lineups. Interesting.
Heck yeah. I like that too. Very cool.
So a couple weeks away. Yeah.
Well, you'll be plenty practiced up if you're practicing tonight, I would say.
Yeah. And actually, our bass player, Robert, is not going to be able to make that show. And so we've practiced tonight with Steve Bravante from Steve's Guitar Shop. And
cool.
He used to play in the 4-Day Beard.
Hey.
And so he's going to sit in for that show. So we're practicing with him, and things went really well, and looking forward to it.
That's great. Freaking exciting. Hey, in this moment, are you feeling like you'd like to go first and rip the Band-Aid off, or could you use an opener?
Kind of a Band-Aid guy.
All right. Let's do it. I'll mute myself out of respect.
Okay, so I just wanted to say that the song that I'm playing tonight is the last time that I was on the single song show, I played a song that I was currently writing. I had like one verse written. So tonight I'm going to play the completed song, and it's called Taking Time. And I'll just go for it, I guess. You went and changed your mind. I've been taking my time. Everything's about to change. It's so hard. I'm holding space. Tell you the truth. Get so scared, but I know it's gonna be alright. You've got things to say. I've been feeling the same way. We've had a few big years. Getting better, letting go of fear. Truth, I get so scared. Gonna be alright. I wouldn't move every what the morning light's gonna show. What could it do to be different anyway? Keep the sun from bringing a new day. Tell you the truth, get so scared, but I know it's gonna be alright.
Yay!
Thank you.
What a freaking special thing to be able to hear that song evolve this way.
Yeah, I thought it would be fun. Also, I was planning to do it on acoustic again tonight, but I decided to do it on electric. And
gonna spice it up.
Were the levels okay? I actually wasn't sure.
They're okay. It got a little loud at one point, but I think that it adjusted. Like, you know what? I think it served it too.
The heavy strumming.
Yeah. Why not? Very cool.
What are you going to play tonight?
Hi, by the way. He wants out. Don't you? Wouldn't be a 90th show without a little guest appearance. Rocket. Say hi.
Hey, buddy.
Of course he's here. But I'm gonna let him out now because he's being a crybaby.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
Thank you.
So did you sort of evolve that one on your own or with the band?
A little bit of both. I spent some more time like fleshing out, you know, more lyrics, and then definitely worked with the band on kind of, you know, working through some of the dynamics and mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very cool. Well, that's exciting, and that's yet another context in which you can hear that song, is with the full band treatment. We've gotten a taste of the acoustic version now.
On June 11th at the Rack and Tour Room.
That's right, June 11th at the Tour Room. You can hear that song in its full band glory. I felt like doing a cover tonight. And actually, you guys can tell me in the comments, or you can tell me yourself if you still want me to do this. But I originally thought, hey, my kids watch a lot of YouTube, and that ad with Paul Rudd and Seth Rogen keeps popping up where they're like, it's a Lay's commercial. And they're like, remember when we went on that road trip in 1997? And they sing Shania Twain, "You're Still the One." And I was like, oh, my friend Karen taught me that song. And I play that song. That would be kind of fun to do. And like, 90th episode kind of 2-year mark thing. That could be fun.
Cool. Very cool.
But I decided against that. So what I'm saying is, whatever, if you still want to do Shania Twain on single song shows at some point, I will do that for you. However, I opted instead, as I was sort of flipping around through things, to do a Randy Newman song by way of Harry Nilsson, a person I've always admired for his insistence on not touring. It just felt fitting. So, and the song is called I'll Be Home, which I have been this whole time. All right, Greta, for you, I'll do Shania Twain next time. But tonight you're getting Harry Nilsson. Nilsson sings Newman. Meredith sings Nilsson sings Newman is what you're getting. All right. I'll be home. I'll be home. When nights are troubled and you're all alone, when you're feeling down and need some sympathy, there's no one else around to keep you company. Remember, baby, you can always count on me. I'll be home, I'll be home, I'll be home. I'll be home, I'll be home. Wherever you may wander, wherever you may roam, you come back and I'll be waiting here for you. No one else will ever love you the way I do. I'll be here to comfort you and see through. I'll be home, I'll be home, I'll be home. There we go.
Hey, beautiful.
Thanks. I like that one. Kind of a lullaby, and I'm a sucker for lullabies.
Yeah, it's getting about that time, too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man. Hey, since the last time you were on the show, I was not yet asking my little question that I like, which is, since this began in the age of pandemic and peak media, what was the last thing that you watched and loved?
The last thing that I watched and loved.
Yes.
Like on TV or like a movie?
Yeah. Anything. Play.
I don't know.
You don't know? Anything lately you haven't seen a movie and gone, wow, what an experience.
Not really any movies that have wowed me lately.
Could be a long time ago.
Okay, so there's a record that I had discovered during the pandemic. I've been a fan of Mark Lanegan's for a bit. And so I discovered this record that was a collaboration with another guy that I can't remember his name, but it's called With Animals, and it's like really dark, and but it's got like synth and like reverse guitars and like and it's really, really mellow. But, and so, yeah, I fell in love with that record.
That's amazing. So Mark Lanegan with Animals?
Yes.
Sweet. I love that. Very cool. Yeah, I think that Watched can be as nebulous as it to be.
What about you? Do you have something that you've watched or experienced that you love?
That I watched and loved. I think I said the same thing last time, but we just wrapped up Russian Doll like 2 nights ago. And I loved that show. I didn't agree. You know, not every decision made in it was like, that was perfect.
I think we started to watch that, and I can't remember why we didn't continue, because I think it was good. I think we just got distracted with something else and didn't come back. But
yeah, I know that when we started watching it, like at the beginning, before you get used to like this is Natasha Lyonne and her whole deal, you kind of go like, "What is this over the top person?" Like, who talks like this?
Mm-hmm.
This, what's happening?
I'll have to go revisit.
Yeah, but then once you get used to it and you're like, oh, that's actually just kind of how she is, like, as a person as well as this character,
mm-hmm.
then, yeah, she's funny and the show is really creative. A lot of interesting twists and very emotional resonance. Too. A lot of emotional resonance, I should say.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good endorsement, so we'll have to check it out.
Yeah. Very cool. And, okay, so you've got Raconteur Room, June 11th, Atascadero, California.
Mm-hmm.
Also, you've got Somnium on Bandcamp, the last full-length album.
That is absolutely correct. Yeah, on Bandcamp. We also have vinyl records available on Bandcamp and our website. And then, I mean, CDs, I don't know who buys CDs anymore, but we have them. If nothing else, it's a great way to support artists to buy a physical piece of merchandise compared to streaming, which doesn't pay artists really anything at all. So,
absolutely.
I mean, I always try to, like, bands that I see live, I try to like buy a piece of merch or something just to support it, even if I don't have a CD player anymore, you know.
Yeah, for sure. We bought your vinyl and we have it and we cherish it, and I think you even threw in your other album on CD because you're
I did
one person
stickers and pins, I think.
Oh yeah. And you have your own postcards as merch, which
we have. I don't know how many of those we have left, but, but yeah, we've got a couple of like pretty cool ones. I've been trying to think of other merch ideas, but I think probably have to, I don't know, start playing more regularly for that to even be a thing. But
yeah, I have all kinds of wacky ideas for merch all the time. And I don't ever seem to get around to making them. I don't know. If you want wacky merch ideas.
Yeah, let's start a list together and see what we can come up with.
Yeah, crowdsource it. See what people think. Cool. All right. What are anything else you want to share before we probably just go to bed?
No, just thank you for having me on again. It's been awesome. I've enjoyed your show every week.
Thank you.
Almost every week.
Yeah.
I think it's amazing. You've been doing this for 2 years and 90 episodes. That's pretty cool.
It's been a wonderful thing in my life. So I'm grateful for everyone who tunes in and everyone who's become my friend through this whole thing. Just like you.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Awesome.
Thank you for being a part of it. Thank you, everyone, for listening. Everybody take good care and be safe and all of that. Tell your cats hello.
Yeah, they're running around somewhere.
You're back to two cats.
Yeah, the new one is interesting. He's very shy, but he's taken to pooping in strange places that are not the litter box, which is not the best thing. So we're gonna figure out how to deal with that, but
yeah,
but he's sweet. He's 3 years old. He's a tabby, and he's missing one eye. But it doesn't really seem to slow him down. He's playing with the other cat, Lily, and it's actually kind of like standing up to Lucy the dog, because Lucy is four times the size of the cat, but wants to play with them, but they don't know what's going on, and she's a lot. So, but he's starting to stand up to her and like swat at her when she gets a little bit too rambunctious. So that's good.
Yeah, that is good. It's nice when they can self-advocate.
Yeah.
Well, cool. I hope it continues. And I wish you and the whole gang over there well. Until next time, hopefully we'll
All
meet
right.
June 11th. And have a good night. Thanks
All right,
again.
Have a good night.
Bye.